Leon will be back with us tonight at 6 o'clock for a concert you won't want to miss. Doors open at 5 o'clock. The doors will open at 5 o'clock right here at Word of Faith Family Church. That's I-35 at the Valley View exit, 6 o'clock tonight. But right now, we want to welcome a man who God has really blessed. He goes across the world teaching, preaching, ministering, declaring that Jesus Christ is Lord, and he is our pastor of Word of Faith Family Church. Let's welcome Robert Tilton.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah. Now tell three people around you Jesus is the Lord of your life, and you may be seated. And they overcame by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. Jesus said, if you're not ashamed of me, I will not be ashamed of you. He said, if you will acknowledge me before men, I will acknowledge you before my Father and before my angels. How many of you know you have a guardian angel? How many of you know the angels of the Lord encampeth about them that put their trust in God? Angels are a very important part of the kingdom of God. They're always beholding us and the face of the Father. Howbeit, are not the angels of God the chariots of God? Are they not special messengers? Are they not ministering spirits, ministering and serving the heirs of the kingdom of heaven? The angels of God. Did you know the angels of the Lord, in many cases throughout the Bible, they would stop the mouths of lions? They would go ahead and prepare and prosper God's servants' ways. The angels of God would wrestle and make sure that the answer to prayers would come. Even as Gabriel came and wrestled the angel that had the message for Daniel and Lucifer withheld and withstood him. But Gabriel came and so that the message could come. The angels of God. Does not God's word teach us that be nice to strangers, for we may be entertaining angels unaware? It's amazing. I remember one Sunday, it was a Saturday night, I was asleep, but all of a sudden I found myself in church. I looked in the back and there stood two angelic beings dressed in the most beautiful heavenly garb, the most beautiful robes that I'd ever seen. They were not natural. Made the nicest thing that we have here look like rags. You know, God likes nice things. And they were dressed in those beautiful heavenly robes. And they had kind of breast necklaces or something on out of ringlets of wool. It was like ringlets of wool about the size of my finger. It was shaped in a V across their chest. One was gold and one was silver. I looked at their faces and they were twins. They looked exactly alike. How many of you know God likes twins? He likes triplets, quadruplets. I mean, you know, sometimes when you think you got God put in a corner, you don't. You don't put God in a box. Some people try to limit God to just this is the way God does it, and if anybody does it any other way, it's not God. That's religion. Man limits God, but faith releases God. Did you know without faith it's impossible to please Him? In Hebrews, the 11th chapter says, without faith it is impossible to please God. For he that cometh to God must believe that He is. Is that all? What else? And He is a rewarder to those that diligently seek Him. God is a rewarder. Everybody say with me, God is a rewarder. He rewards those who seek Him. In today's society economy, there's all kinds of false prophets and lukewarm bugle blowers that are not making the sound of the life of God. When God spoke the worlds into existence, He spoke the stars, the trees, and the waters. And He said, and let the waters bring forth fish abundantly. You fishermen out there ought to say amen to that. He didn't say, let there be a few little fish, three or four tadpoles. He said, let the waters bring forth fish abundantly.